welcome back to the Kids Economy. So in our previous lesson, we talked about that intricate relationship of supply and demand within the economy. So let's go over some examples of supply and demand, okay? First example, imagine that a popular video game has just been released, okay? The demand for the game is high because many kids want to play it. However, initially, the supply is limited. This creates a situation where the game is in high demand, but it's not readily available in stores. And as a result, the price of the game might be higher than usual. Over time, as more copies of the game are produced and become available, the supply increases and the price may go down. Another example is, let's say, a famous music artist announces a concert in your city. Okay, the demand for tickets will be high because many fans want to attend the show. However, the number of available tickets is limited due to the capacity of the venue. As a result, the demand exceeds supply, and the tickets may sell out quickly. In such cases, people may be willing to pay higher prices for the tickets from resellers or scalpers. Imagine a pair of popular shoes, okay? These are limited edition shoes and everyone wants to have them. So the demand for these shoes will be high among shoe enthusiasts and collectors because there's very limited amount of them. And the supply is limited because only a certain number of pairs are produced and they're not gonna make any more. So this limited supply creates a situation where the shoes are in high demand and some people may be willing to pay higher prices or even participate in an auction, or they might wait in long lines to get their hands on a pair. Okay, that is all created by supply and demand. Think about a fruit, okay? Think about a fruit that is only available in a certain time of year. It only grows in the springtime, okay? So let's just think of strawberries or watermelons. So when these fruits are in season, the supply is high because they are readily available in stores and at lower prices. So there's a lot of supply there. Many people will buy them and enjoy them. However, when the season is over, the supply decreases and the prices may go up because they become more scarce. They become less of them available. The supply is less. This creates a situation where the demand remains. Okay, people still like strawberries in December, but the supply is limited, leading to higher prices for fruits when they're out of season. Okay, so you'll notice in the store that the price of a strawberry or watermelon or an avocado is different in one point of the year compared to another, or at least it should be. So these examples demonstrate how supply and demand can influence the availability, price, and desirability of products or services in everyday life. And by understanding these concepts, you can better understand why certain items may be more expensive or harder to find, depending on the level of supply and demand from consumers.